as I saw families riding on two-wheelers, the little kid standing in front of the father driving the vehicle, the mother sitting in the back holding a child, and I thought, my God, this is a really tough way for someone to travel, both in safety and in comfort. He interviewed me and he asked about what would this sell for, and I said about 100,000 rupees, and that became the headline. And I had two choices. One was to refute it, or the other was to take it on as a target. We chose the...
No one in their right mind believes that a 1 lakh car is possible.
What makes the world keep evolving and changing? The constant quest for excellence. The desire to think fresh. To constantly innovate, reimagine, design and discover new and better technology. For people, for a better world. Let's go on a journey of how one such innovation comes to life.
Next, we see how the supply chain works. Now, let's look at the suppliers and procurement. The suppliers of Tata Nano are divided into different tiers. Here is an example. Tier 3 suppliers sell to Tier 2 suppliers, Tier 2 to Tier 1, who in turn sell to the original equipment manufacturers. Tata Motors does all the sourcing from OEMs who are categorized as proprietary suppliers. Here we see some of Tata Nano. As proprietary design partners, Tata Nano also uses in-house design components and systems which are sourced from suppliers with strong process capabilities. Together with proprietary design suppliers and in-house design suppliers, Tata Nano sources over 2,000 parts from over 175 suppliers. The OEM supplies parts to the factory for the assembly and subsequent production of Tata Nano cars. Tata Motors uses the unique SAP supplier relationship management portal to interact with the OEMs. It helps to forecast purchasing behavior, shorten procurement cycles so as to work more efficiently with their supplier pool. They also have region-wise consolidation centers so as to decrease the number of individual trips to the plant. Here all the different supplier parts are consolidated in a single location and are sent to the manufacturing. Let's move our attention towards the plant and the inventory.
To make his dream come true, Tata has pinned his hopes on a purpose-built megafactory near the town of Sanand in the state of Gujarat. It's a sprawling 450-hectare complex of massive workshops linked by roads and sky bridges. The workforce of 2,300 mostly get here by bus or a trusty motorcycle. The factory is made up of five main sections. The engine and transmission are assembled in the powertrain building. Sheet metal is pressed into panels in the press shop. The weld shop assembles the panels into a body, which is sent across a skybridge to the paint shop. All the parts come together in the trim, chassis and finish, or TCF shop. When it gets up to speed, this factory can produce 350,000 nanos a year. It boasts state-of-the-art automation and over 130 robots that would be right at home in Japan.
In Sanand plant, we follow the Kaizen methodology and we have kept our SOP for 45 days stocking as far as Sanand nanos are concerned. And as already we had seen in the market, the sales of the Nano is dipping day by day. So we had kept in mind and we had to start doing production of our other hatchback cars with our forthcoming cars. And for this, the inventory norms will go up to excellent. The transporters who are working with the Sanand plant is actually the same transporter who are working for all the major OEMs, 18 major OEMs, who basically takes cars or utility vehicles from their plant and deliver to dealer level. Suppose I am taking an example that from Sanand, some transporter had taken the 8 vehicle slot of my Nano and delivered to Lucknow, and from Lucknow he will directly go to Gurgaon, where he take the 8 Maruti cars and deliver to Ahmedabad. So on a safer side, the transporter gets the higher volumes, higher payment basis, and the no site is basically vacant for transport.
Next comes the distribution. Tonino has over 450 dealers working in the country. Here is an example of a dealer sourcing the cars from the production plant. Each dealer keeps 3 variants of Tata Nano, and each variant has a safety stock of 5 cars. Once the inventory drops below 5, shipping request is triggered to the regional office. The transport management team processes the order using TMS portal and sends it to the plant. The plant sends a lot of cars to the closest distribution center. The distributor subsequently dispatches the requisite number of Tata Ninos to the concerned dealer. And finally, it all comes back to the consumer.
This is the end, beautiful friend. This is the end, my own.